Hello, my name is Uwe Weinmann. I'm the senior manager of the Dry Support Group. Today I will show you how to commission Safe Motion, which we abbreviate with SMO. First of all, I would like you, as told in our how-tos, which are available in the ctrlX automation community, to make the usual startup for a normal drive where you functionally enable the drive but have it for safe motion not active. After you have done that and everything moves, like in here, say if I starting the easy startup mode, enable it and chuck the drive. As you see in here, we are now at 17.35 millimeters, and if I chuck it, then it moves. After you have accomplished that, now we stop the easy startup mode and we now enable the safe motion functionality. How do we do that? First, we functionally lock the drive, which means we disable it in here. Then we activate the safe motion SMO in here, which means either we have to set up now a new password, or in here I already put up a safety password, which I just need to enter once again in here. Safe motion is activated, and now we can go through what is called the initial commissioning whilst in configuration mode, which you see in here and as well resembled by the CM letters in here. So go to initial commissioning. First, the system asks us to once again confirm the safe motion access identifier, which now means it loads the default settings in here. We go in here next. We need to once again put in a password we have to remember. We need to confirm it once again. Go to next. The system asks us to name the access with a clear and one-time access identifier. Now I put in here linear access version 01, write the access identifier to the system. Whenever we put in here something, we have to verify this by applying it. Now we need to identify the safe motion if we are really connected to the right axis. Now directly on the axis itself, the drive, we should see a green or red always changing LED in here. If it's the right axis we are talking to, we apply the axis identifier. Now this assignment was successful. We can go on to the next step. First thing, we have to apply the encoder data from the standard firmware to safe motion. So we just do that by pressing here this button. Now we have to make sure where is the safe encoder fastened to which interface. In here we have chosen the XG20, the digital encoder interface. Our safe motion encoder now is applied to. We apply this encoder data in here by pressing the button. Successful in here. We just go on to the next slide, and in here now automatically, as we have chosen the XG20 as our safe motion encoder, now the Acura Link interface encoder has been put in here with all its numbers. We apply that. Takes a small certain while. We can go on with next. If there would be a difference where this encoder is fastened to, but in here on our demo system it is on the motor side, so we just can go on, otherwise we would have to enter the appropriate figures in here. Now, similar like the encoder data, we now apply the scaling data from the standard firmware to the safe motion by pressing this button. Now it was successful, though we can go on after we quitted this small remark in here. As you see in here now, there comes a yellow marked different number showing up. By checking all these, we apply them in here. By pressing next, we come to what was taken over from the standard firmware, like the maximum travel range, the feed constant, the gear ratio in here, if it's a modulo or absolute format axis. If we go into from the polarity, positive or negative, which we already established in the standard firmware. Now we apply these figures in here and go on with the next figure we have to establish, and in here we have to tell what the velocity threshold for the safe standstill is. Like say in here it is set to 100 millimeter per minute, which is a quite good figure, and we keep it in here. With pressing next, if we have a brake present, we should have the safe brake control activated in here. So in here, as we have a safe brake, we keep it. So we go for next. In here, as we want to use now the safe motion without safety bus communication, we as well press next. And now, as we want to make it use with the ctrlX safety link, we apply now what we put in here in the checkbox and the radio button. We don't use in here additional local safe inputs, so we just can go on in here and now need to apply our safe connection, which is established with a ctrlX safety link input 1 assigned in here to the emergency stop signal in our case. That is how the hardware is wired. Now we go to the next network. There we are using once again a safe connector. This time we take the ctrlX safety link input 2, but now an acknowledge to the mode selection signal. Once again, we have to apply this configuration. Select the next safe connection. Now, of course, in here we are using the ctrlX safety link input 3, assigned now to the enabling control signal. Once again, apply it. Go to the next network, and as we are using in here only one safe motion mode, we put that directly in here to the SMM1 as a safe constant selection. As we don't need to configure any other networks, we can just check this checkbox, press next, and we would be able in configuring a local safe output in here, but as we don't use it in here, we just... Oh, Jesus, I have a little bit shrink the screen. We go here to the next. And now the system is asking us to establish, if wanted, if we are monitoring the safe maximum speed. As I know in here, our safe normal maximum speed is 15 meters per minute. I set it in here to around 18,000 millimeter per minute, means 80 meter per minute in here. Once again, we apply it. We don't distinguish in monitoring the direction in here. We as well put in here, say, a safe monitoring if we are in safe standstill. I put it in here to 2 millimeters and apply it. We go on in next. As we made one safe motion active, we select in here how longest I can press the enabling pendant signal. We put it now to 60 seconds. Usually, as in here, I have the idea of making a machine tool axis work. We set the safe limited speed to 2000 millimeter per minute. We don't have any safely monitored transient oscillation or safe limited increment active, so we just apply these figures in here. And just apply it once again. And as we have no other safe motion mode active, like SSN2, we just can put in here that we don't parameterize any other safe motion. Go to next. And now we can establish how our transition from whatever movement to safe standstill, how it should look like. Usually on control-based systems, we would like to have it NC controlled. Usually in here, now we do it SS1 time prioritized. But we are monitoring, so that's done in SIL3, but we are doing the deceleration with SIL2, as we are just looking through the RAM. We should not distinguish, say, if the SMM selection has a tolerance between both channels. If we are already in the right conditions, then of course we can directly switch over. In here, this ramping down is done directly based in here, that's at least my recommendation, based on the actual velocity. We allow a certain small oscillation in here, and as we have now put it NC controlled, we allow the system to react a small reaction time, like 10 milliseconds for the NC to take over. If we are then on the velocity window, then we put that to 200 millimeter per minute. We are not implementing here SMD jerk, but we are having here the deceleration where this safe motion monitoring goes on. Usually we recommend in here about 60% of the value normally active for the normal operation. As well in here, if we take here into account the 2 meter per second from 15 meter per second squared, then that takes around 0.5 seconds. So now we put in here a little bit more in here. Similarly in here, same for the normal operation to safe motion. And if we would have several different safe operation modes or safe motion modes, then of course to come from the one to the other, then it would be a little bit less, like 0.5 2 seconds. We apply all these different figures in here, our entries, and go to the next. In here, first step is we apply the normal error reaction of the dry now as well for safe motion. It's done already in here. Similarly to the 0.6 seconds we had in before, we now select slightly more, like 0.65, and similarly as well in here the F7 tolerance time. Similar, we put here the 500 millimeter per second in, and as we did in before as oscillation. In here we leave a small additional reaction time, like 5 milliseconds. Put in here the 200 millimeter per minute as we did in before, and put in the deceleration similarly to what we did in before, 2000 millimeter per second squared. And once again, as well, we don't use the SMD jerk in here. We apply the stuff. And go to the next step, where we can select, say, the additional support functions. In here we leave everything except on the command value monitoring active, though that we are done in here. Now automatically the safe motion report is being generated, which we can use later on to just copy once again the same parameters, but then of course with changed serial numbers. And it is recommended to put this safe motion report to your actual machine in order to tell, come on, okay, that were the axis, which is now identified in here with linear axis version 01, with now the serial number and all the settings in here, as one can see in here, that's all the different stuff we are available in here. So, okay, we exit in here. We can easily go over to operation mode. And now, as we have now this starting point and our system using this ctrlX safety link with in conjunction with the ctrlX safety control, it starts up with the emergency stop active. And as I have on the other side, the small axis in here, it is configured still in the configuration mode. I put it now as well to the operation mode and come back to my initial axis in here, where I can now reset. Reset problem showing up in here, going up to the operation mode again. We can make it work. Okay, we have of course in before to connect it properly. That's what I didn't do in before. So my ctrlX safety link was broken. I have to reconfigure it in here. And now one sees of course as well that we can easily take it over in here. Can reset in here. And now we are back, that everything is okay in here right now. By selecting the emergency stop button at our ctrlX safety, you see now that in here we get the emergency stop active. If I once again release it and reset it, we are now back to the normal mode in here, AB. If we use the mode selection, we are switching over to the special mode in safe standstill. If we as well additionally press the enabling control button, we are getting here to SMM1, the special mode safe motion 1 active. If I release the enabling pendant once again, we are back to SMSD2, the special mode for safe standstill. If I put over the mode select switch again, I'm back to normal operation mode. That's what I wanted to show to you, how easy you make the safe motion work. Keep in touch with us and keep always in mind ctrlX automation 2 steps ahead. Bye bye.